Let me ask you guys this. Have you ever wondered what it would be like to win every single fight like Clicks and Reed does? Whew, man, that would be a dream. Bunch of Crunch Army, where you at? Your motivation guy is back. And you know, winning fights in Fortnite is beyond crucial, bro. You know, you can only get so far being a bush camper, so you know, you guys gotta get better at fighting, and so we wanna get better together, right? We're gonna be analyzing and learning from three of the finest fighters, Reet, Furious, and Clicks. And you know, these guys have been absolutely dominating recently, so we gotta take a look and just see some of their fights and just see what incredible tips and tricks that we can really just pick up and just really use for ourselves. And don't forget to like and subscribe, and make sure to check out ProGuys.com if you want to take your game to the next level with pro coaching and so much more. Save time and get good quickly. So check us out at the link in the description. So to start things off, we're going to be looking at two clips from a controller player who has it all right now, Reet from Extra Gaming. All right, Reet was playing on a different region these games, so we're going to see how he fights on higher ping and also a couple of tricks for using and countering shockwave grenades. All right, guys, so in this clip, Reet arrives at the Fancy View Beach House and he hears a player inside. So he comes for protection and look, there's the enemy trying to be all sneaky. The fight begins and Reet goes for a pump shot into a wall placement, which he edits to attempt a cone block. But unfortunately, he cannot build because the game says no. Anyways, all right, he ends up taking quite a bit of damage here, so he backs up to heal. All right, so one thing that he did right away was switch to metal when he got sprayed at. All right, fighting with wood is okay, guys, but nothing beats brick and metal, man, especially with a spray happy opponent. Though once Reet heals up, he heads outside to face his opponent and they ramp each other off. So Reet does this side jump and he boxes up to heal. But he gets pressured really hard, so he expands out a few more boxes, and instead of just wasting time, you know, trying to pop minis versus someone with a spray weapon, he just uses his chug. Now it's time to get aggressive, so Reet goes in. He can't take height, but he's got to save retake. Notice how he edits his floor and immediately cones above to prevent the enemy from editing their own floor. Pretty smart, right? So afterwards, Reet edits his own floor and he places a backward ramp for protection so he can just jump up. And at this point, man, like, I really don't know what his opponent is trying to do, but they're acting all skirmish. Reet goes up to break the ramp, but anticipating an edit, he pulls out his shotgun and he cracks their shields. So to finish this off, okay, Reet ramp phases in, he breaks the ramp, and he cones, which actually ends up blocking his opponent's shockwave grenade. So it doesn't end up doing anything, and just like that, Reet picks up the kill. Yo, GG outplayed. Okay, we're gonna recap this in a second, but let's take a look at this next clip. Reet pushing this player boxed up in a single 1v1. So he sets up this shockwave exploit, a ramp two tiles away from their box, a wall behind it, and a floor at the bottom of the ramp. He stands close to the ramp and he tosses a shockwave at the floor, which yeets him directly into his opponent's box. There really isn't much to say, you know, about the rest of this clip. Reet chunks this guy for tons of damage and he tries to peace control, yet they do slip away. But eventually, the whole lobby focuses on this guy and Reet can just jump in right behind him and he secures the limb. Okay, so what do we learn from these two clips? All right, first off, switch to hard mats when getting sprayed at, man. Like we said, fighting with wood, yeah, I mean, it's okay. But if you want every advantage possible, which I do, I don't know about you, but I know I do, especially on higher pings, fight with metal or brick. All right, second, guys, chug splashes are the best non-fish healing items for fights. Okay, they're not as easy to find as minis, I get it, but they can be used nearly instantaneously. And Reet needed that since he was getting sprayed at. Third, you can block shockwave grenades with a cone. So I don't think Reet really did this one on purpose, but there's definitely enough time to react once you hear the noise, and it's gonna prevent your opponent from flying away. And lastly, you can safely shockwave exploit into boxes with Reet set up here. Again, okay, a ramp two tiles away from the box, a wall behind it, and a floor that you toss the shockwave on. You can add more walls for protection too. It is extremely simple and really only needs like a minute of practice to really get it down. So definitely, guys, add this one to your playbook if you haven't already. Got it? Cool. All right, so for this next fighter, y'all, I'm pumped up. We've got first place DreamHack winner Furious in a grueling off-spawn battle at Lazy Lake. Check this out, bro. The tricks that he used to win this fight are not new or anything like that, but trust me when I say this. Yo, the way he played was brilliant. All right, starting off, Furious is busy farming when another pro, G-Money, starts whacking at his wall. Furious tries to edit and trap him with the floor, an excellent move, may I add, but unfortunately carried out too slowly. A bit of time passes and G-Money drops down, so what Furious does is get his back up against the wall so he can just execute this ramp face trick right here. Basically, anytime you got your back touching the wall behind you, you can just drop a ramp and it's gonna be stuck in a face state allowing you to shoot. Okay, edit the wall in front of you or do whatever as if it wasn't there. Sadly, Furious doesn't hit his shot here and eventually G-Money backs off. Okay, so for the next couple of minutes, Furious just keeps farming mats and he keeps working on his loadout when sneaky G-Money actually returns, but this time, crouch walking to conceal his footsteps. G-Money bursts through and he traps Furious with peace control. This makes Furious panic, so he shockwaves. So the first one doesn't work, but the second one is enough to get him to safety. And at this point, a long game of cat and mouse ensues. Furious does a spectacular job, you know, evading G-Money, constantly tunneling, you know, expanding his builds and moving from room to room, making sure to utilize the natural maze-like layout of these buildings to hide from G-Money, which is dope. However, let me say this, G-Money's doing a great job following along as well. Furious holds this right hand angle while popping his pop, sees G-Money approach, but still gets tagged and combed in. Yet by some miracle, he slips away. Furious tries to pop another mini here, but G-Money traps him with the ramp, so he just slips through the wall and he gets Furious down to critical health. Now, you gotta watch this here, and I mean like right here. G-Money sets up the ramp exploit to get into Furious's box, but Furious sees it and he jumps forward and out as G-Money enters. Wow, yo, this move is actually a very viable method of countering the ramp phase and really allows Furious to escape his own death here. All right, moving on. Furious had just about enough, so he sets up another ramp phase around this corner, he edits the wall, and he pre-aims right at head height. And just like that, guys, G-Money comes running into his crosshair, and Furious gets the kill. From G-Money's perspective, he turns the corner, and he only really sees a ramp. So he probably wasn't expecting Furious to be able to actually shoot him there. Yo, not gonna lie, pretty clever Furious to set up this technique around a corner so that he could create a right-hand advantage. So, what's the takeaway here from Furious's play? All right, let me say this. First, shockwaves make for a fantastic panic button. He used his to escape getting peace controlled, which should honestly be anyone's first instinct when in a sticky situation like this. Second, creating distance is crucial to survive bad situations. Furious made sure, man, to constantly expand and run back and forth between buildings, as well as up and down floors to create distance before trying to pop meds. Third, let me say this. You can counter the ramp exploit by jumping forward out of your box as your opponent enters, and then you can wall behind you to just close them off. And fourth, the ramp phase technique works so much better when set up with a right-hand peek. Furious used the ramp phase technique around the corner inside this building, creating a right-hand peek and making it so G-Money couldn't even see him that easy. All right, so we're gonna get into clicks really, really soon here, but if you want similar analysis done for your own games, guys, yo, you gotta check out Pro Guys, where you can upload your gameplay and get a detailed review in under 24 hours. It's nuts, it's insane. I can't believe we actually do this. So to find out what you're doing wrong today, you gotta check out ProGuides.com. All right, so to finish things off, we gotta take a look at Big Clicks playing an EU DreamHack. He had 90 ping here, quite a disadvantage, but let's see what tricks he had up his sleeve. So, Clix is rotating in a car when a bush camper beams him for massive damage. Whew. Clix immediately builds a 2x1, which works better than a 1x1 since it allows him to create a right-hand peek for his edit. He inflicts about 100 damage, evening this fight, but here's the thing. His opponent heals up and Clix hears a car approaching, so even with this awesome outplay, he's still in a pretty, pretty lousy spot. So, what does Clix do? He chills. But his opponent is not chilling though. So he blows up a gas can, but Clix rebuilds and he starts looking for another tag. That's when the third party joins the fight. So Clix employs one of my favorite strats. Hiding in a metal cone in here, and I mean like right here, he can just hang out. You know, he can hold the edit to get a nice view and he can just wait for an unsuspected opponent to approach. Mr. Third Party here doesn't see it at all. So Clix pounces on him and he lands the pump into an immediate wall, edits the wall to cone him, and then straight up just mops the floor with this guy. All right, guys, so what were the key pointers here? Here we go. Well, let me say this. The 2x1 is essential in this meta, and it really allowed Clix to quickly reposition to a right-hand angle so that when he made his edit, he had an inherent advantage. Also, hiding in a cone works wonders when pressured by a third party. It's like one of the oldest tricks in the book, yet people still really fall for it. So if you ever need to hide during a fight, consider your cone, all right? Just make sure it's full of HP so you don't get spotted. And lastly, it's a good idea to follow up your shotgun shot by placing a wall, edit it open, and coning, aka boxing in an enemy. In this case, Clix's opponent was already on a cone they didn't own, so Clix only needed to cone the top. But on regular ground, both the top and bottom should be coned for full piece control. All right, guys, once again, it's your motivation guide. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. You know, I really hope this analysis really helped you learn a little something when it comes to fighting. So let me know in the comments, you know, if you did this, you know, if it worked for you and what tip you really found most helpful. And if you guys enjoyed the video, hey, do us a favor, you know, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel with the bell button on so you do not miss any of our future videos, okay? And yo, that's it for me. You know, you guys better have an awesome day. Bunch of crunch, Army. Where you at? Here we go. Keep eating that bunch of crunch and let's get this going.